Hello everybody and welcome for the third episode of Flair 101. I hope you practice well the previous routine because today we will learn two new moves. One of these moves will be complex and deserve quite a lot of hours of practicing. Let me show you what we will learn today.
1 hour later. 3 hours later. 1 eternity later.
Before we start the routine, I would like to focus your practicing on 2-3 specific moves. The first one will be the throw on the back, okay? So yesterday when we throw the bottle on our back, we grab the bottle on the body, the target was the left side of our hips, and we throw it from the right hands to the right hands. Remember, your hands need to be facing the sky when you grab it. Today, what will be different is we not hold the bottle on the body, but on the neck. We will throw the bottle from the right side to the left side. When you will throw the bottle on your back, grab the neck of the bottle. And the three last fingers are not that important. The most important is the thumb and the index. These two fingers pinch the bottle. When you put the bottle on the side, you have to go up. As you can see, the direction of my bottle stay the same. And when I arrive approximately at the same size than my eyes, my head, then I will open my finger to release the finger. So I start low, I go up, 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 open, and the bottle will come on your back. When you do that move, it should be one motion. So don't go up, stop, and after, you try to throw it, because you will put power and this power will make spin the bottle. Hold it, you go up, 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 leave it. This is the motion to do. For the second move, you only need the shaker. And the first training that we did together, I teach you how to throw the shaker and make it stable. Now, we will do the same exercise, but instead we throw it front of us, we will throw it from the back to the front, from the left hand to the right hand. Same than last time, when we start the move, place your hands facing the sky, shaker opening facing the customer. And after, you can do it on the side. As you can see, the shaker, not this time, the shaker is stable and stay in the same position. You throw it, you go and catch it. The second move that we will focus our practicing will be how to spin the shaker. I will grab the shaker on the top. It's important because it will make the rotation easier. And when you want to make it spin, I will go with my hands on the right side, pull the shaker and catch it when I will be on the left side. Go on the right, pull, catch on the right. As you can see, the bottle do that circle. It is important. This is how you will avoid spill, because when we will make spin the shaker, we will also pour inside. The routine will start like the level 2. Grab the bottle on the body, throw it, and now you will catch the neck, because we will do our change on the back. That's why it is very important to practice this move perfectly, and in a second time to practice this one, because now we will combine both of them in one move. When you do this move, you will see that the shaker and the bottle follow two different lines, two different directions. The bottle stays on the top and the shaker will come from the bottom. Respect that line, because this is how you will be able to do that move properly. A common mistake also is to not throw the bottle enough high And when you throw the shaker, then the shaker will take that line. Let's do it again from the beginning. Shaker left hand, bottle right hand, and I grab it on the body. I throw the bottle, grab the neck. I make jump my shaker. Now my bottle is on the right side. Remember, pinch with your thumb and your index. Prep your arms on the back, and now we can go up, 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 leave it and throw the shaker. Now that I grab the shaker in this position, I'll go and catch it. I will do the same move, but on the other side, and change my bottle on the back. Let's do it again. Shaker opening, facing the customer, and the bottle, you grab it by the body. We throw it, grab the neck, make jump the shaker. Now, when the bottle go on the right side, you will start to put the shaker on your back. Like that, you will be ready for the change. You go up, 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 throw the shaker, and now you can go and catch it. The next part of the routine, we will throw the shaker on our left side and same, we go and catch it. After that, continue the circle, slide our hands on the neck, pass around the head, and now we will learn a different role. That was the first one. That was the second one. And we will learn a third one, which look like that. When you want to do that roll, remember you make slide your hands on the neck, pass around the head, grab the shaker on the top with the index and the thumb. The three other finger, you open it because we will put the neck inside. This finger will help us to control the bottle on the roll until the end of the hands. When you are at the end of your hands, leave the bottle, let the bottle continue the motion and grab the neck. Go on the left side and now my shaker is on the right side. I can give him a spin, catch it on the left and pour the bottle. I can stop, one more spin, it's exactly the same that we did, and you can pour in a normal grip. We are done for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed this training. As you can see, the first routine was very easy, but this one is a little bit more challenging. Probably on the change back, you will struggle a lot. This is perfectly normal. If you like that video, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, to share to your friends, and to practice what I teach you. I will be back soon for a new video where this time I will not teach you a routine, but I will teach you specific move to increase your technique. The first move that I will teach you will be a throw over the shoulder. And if you want to know the second move that I will teach you, then see you in the next video. Peace.